as I was on my deathbed
and was ready for it. I'm not here for all this pain and all this suffering. I can't even walk. I can't even wipe my own.
So.
Let's get into how they diagnosed me. A hematologist asked to draw my blood. And when she drew my blood, she got my blood results back and she couldn't even believe that it was my body. So what was happening in my body was, even though, remember I told you guys, I've been getting my blood drawn a million and one time and my blood says, hey, everything's fine. Your cholesterol's fine. All your regular blood levels are great. You're totally healthy. But that hematologist, she drew the cellular workup. A cellular blood test is totally different from a regular blood test. So if you guys are having problems, if you guys want to start a new diet, if you guys want to try some herbs, some vibe, whatever it is, I advise for people to go get a cellular blood test, because my blood test came back, my ferritin, which is the iron levels in your body, but read through your cells, was 23,000. Ferritin in the body is normally between 100, 200 is considered high. You really don't want to get to the 200s, but it's then more like in the hundreds. So that was the first indicator. My C-reactive proteins were off the chart. So my cells were telling my body what's going on. The mitochondria in my cells, which is the brain of your cell, which tells everybody what to do, how to do it, gone. Checked out, asleep, dormant. It was just done. She immediately thought that I had another very deadly disease. Now, she took my temperature. My temperature was 103.7. 103.7. Okay. So as I was telling her the rest of my symptoms, and she was like, night sweats. She was like, that's not hormonal. She was like, you have a fever. So she's like, I don't know what the hell's going on. I'm admitting you to the hospital. She admits me to the hospital. They test me every 2 hours. Keep me up every 2 hours, this is even during the night, while they try to figure out what's going on. I already look like a heroin addict walking around here. It was just horrible. They wouldn't even use a butterfly needle for me at that point. They were just using regular needles, and I have really tiny veins, so you can imagine what it's like. Finally, they're like, listen, we ran every single test. The only test that we haven't done is a bone marrow test on you, and it is extremely painful, and we don't want to put you through any more pain. I mean, you guys, I was crying, bawling every time I saw the phlebotomist walk in with that damn tray with all those little needles, and I was just like, no, please, no, I can't take no more. The head of hematology, the head of rheumatology worked together to figure out a way to diagnose me. They won't let me sleep longer than 2 hours because they're afraid I'm gonna go into cardiac arrest. They're afraid I'm gonna go into a coma because they can't get my fevers down. We think you have this illness, this autoimmune disease called adult onset Still's disease. I'm gonna say it again. Adult onset Still's, S-T-I-L-L-S, disease. And it's an autoimmune condition. It's a very rare autoimmune condition. And this autoimmune condition is common in, or it's not common, but when it does come up, it's common, more common in children between the ages of 2 and 3. Do you know when they say, don't get the chicken pox when you're older? Because it's going to be bad. This is kind of similar to that. This is something that in children, it's treatable. It doesn't affect them the same way, and they can go on with their lives. But for me, that wasn't the case. Now check this out. I used to get mad throat infections, like really, really sore throats. The funny part is that's one of the main symptoms of adult onset Still's disease, is you get really bad sore throats. So now I'm thinking about all the times that I would get these really crazy sore throats, you know, as a kid, and I would very often. But I mean, we didn't know what it was. We just thought, you know, hey, you're just sick and you'll get over it. And so they were just feeding me antibiotics. My mom would take me to the doctor, I would get antibiotics, which we all know what antibiotics do to your system too. Long story short, they diagnosed me with this disease and they said, listen, you're at a critical point. I've walked around with these fevers way too long. You guys, I don't even remember half of the shit that was going on in my life at that time. My brain was just fried. And so they diagnosed me with this illness, and then they say, well, in order for us to get this thing under control, we're recommending to take chemotherapy. Say what?
What you talking about, doctor?
Chemotherapy, blah, 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 blah. I don't have cancer though. And he's like, oh, we understand that. But just like a cancer would be in your body, a cancer is in there trying to kill everything. Well, this disease, your body is trying to pretty much kill you. It's shutting down all your organs. It's attacked all of your joints in your body. I mean, at this point, the fevers are frying my brain. My body is trying to kill itself. Most of the time when people are sick, the first thing you think is, oh my God, you have a low immune system. That hoe didn't need to be no stronger. She was killing me. She was strong. She was not strong, she was strong, okay? Don't think that just because you're sick is because you have a low immune system or a weak immune system. Some people, especially most of us with autoimmune conditions, is because your immune system is very strong. When you have an autoimmune condition, your white and red blood cells multiply more and more and more and more because it's looking for something to find. It's trying to find something to fight off. That's why the iron in my body was so high, because my blood cells were just multiplying at a crazy rate, increasing my iron. So the chemotherapy was made to kill a cancer. Well, it's also made to kill down an overactive immune system. This chemotherapy that they put me on, they use often in elderly people who have extreme severe rheumatoid arthritis. They also use it for certain cancer patients, but most of the time, and this is another thing that I learned, there's so many different chemotherapy medicines. Chemotherapy isn't a one type of medicine. There is a plethora of them. So the type of chemotherapy that I took, which is even still hard for me to pronounce to this day, is tozoluzumab. I still can't say it properly. But the goal was, all right, we're gonna put you on this medication. We have to get the fevers down immediately. I don't know if your body is gonna make it another night. We wanna try this for a week and see if it works. Mind you, of course, you know what happens when you go on chemotherapy, all the side effects. You're gonna be sick, you're gonna lose your hair. You're gonna go through all types of body weaknesses, mouth ulcers, and a whole lot of other side effects that they don't tell you about, which I have a video about. Side effects of chemotherapy they don't tell you about. It's not just about being nauseous, no. But long story short, they wanted me to try this medicine for a week to see if it would help with my fevers, and it did. By day 5, my fever went down to 102. So that was like, I felt like $1 million. Let's just keep going. They told me it would probably take about 3 to 6 months of me being on this medicine. And it was gonna be a weekly thing, starting off weekly, and then we would taper you down to every 2 weeks, and then we would taper you down to every 3 weeks, and then we would taper you down to every 4 weeks as we progress over these 6 months. It took another 2 weeks for the fevers to completely come down to normal, another 3 months for my joints to finally come down and be normal, and it took another 4 months for the hives to go away. The worst, one of the worst, I feel like the hives were still just the worst symptom of that disease. Along the way, they put me on prednisone. 20 milligrams of prednisone a day. They also put me on, oh my God, the list of medications that I was taking was crazy. And you know, a lot of these side effects, especially the prednisone, is like, listen, you're gonna swell up a little bit. You're gonna have an increase of appetite. You're not gonna be able to sleep. You're gonna be irritable. You're probably gonna have acne. Dang! I mean, I can't win for losing, but I'll take those symptoms over what I'm going through right now. I'll take anything, because at this point, I'm ready. Take me now. I ended up on chemotherapy for a total of 2.5 years. 6 months turned into 2.5 years. I really think that my doctors, and you know, God bless them at the VA, they were kind of scared to take me off the medication, number one. And the first steps before you can get off of chemotherapy, first you have to get off of your medications. You have to completely be off medications for at least 6 months to make sure that you don't have any relapses. Because another thing like chemo, you don't want, whether it's cancer or whatever illnesses, you don't want to relapse. Because if you relapse and you come off your medication, then that bad boy is gonna come back again. And now the same medicine I've been taking to get me down might not work again. So that's the scary thing about being on chemotherapy, is like when you come off of it, you wanna make sure that whatever's going on in your body is done. You don't want to just jump off of it fast. So that was the next deal. So after a year of chemotherapy, then I took 6 months, it's a year and a half now, of coming off the medications. And those medications, especially like prednisone, you have to come off of them slowly. So they decrease you by 2, I was doing 2 milligrams at a time every 2 weeks after my first year of chemotherapy. Finally got off all those medications, that was great. gained 70 pounds, new back acne. My hair fell out, but I didn't go bald because I wasn't on chemo every single day and radiation every single day. That's really, really hardcore treatment for most cancer patients that are at stage 4 and stage 5. After getting off of my medications, then now I was ready to start coming off that trip. That was a whole nother year of just coming off of chemo. They took it so slow, but I'm happy that they did. Now, by the time they were taking me off chemo, this was 2019. Mind you, I went in the hospital 2017. March 18th, 2020 was my last chemotherapy treatment. Today is March 6th, 2021. Next week will make a year that I've been off of chemo. I cannot believe it. I can't believe it. Like, I can't believe it. We about to party. We about to get lit. This journey has been crazy. By the time I get off of chemo, I'm really realizing that my doctors don't know what the f*** they talking about. They put me on this medicine, but it was a blessing in disguise because it made me really dive into why am I sick? I didn't know the difference between a regular blood test and a cellular blood test. So it really opened my eyes to what real healing was. That's how I learned about leaky gut, holistic healing. Natural healing. The last year of chemotherapy was the first time I decided to go see a holistic healer. And boy, what I found out about what's going on in my body is crazy. So now, not only am I seeing natural doctors, but I'm also going through a huge detox phase because after prednisone and montelukast and all these different medications and the chemotherapy, now it's time to really get into the healing. And I think a lot of people don't do that. When you take the Western medicine route and you go through chemotherapy and you go through all the stuff, you think, all right, my doctors are telling me that I'm good now. Mm-mm. That's not the end of it. Don't be like me, end up on the juice. And it's no shade to them. That's what they've been trained for. That's the only thing they know. But I also think that we have a responsibility to ourselves at the end of the day to look outside of that. You gotta go above and beyond. You want optimum health. So that's the whole point of this channel. That's the whole point of my journey. Literally, natural remedies saved my life, you guys, literally. But I really just wanted to share my journey of how I found out I had autoimmune condition, all the symptoms for years leading up to that I ignored. You guys, do not ignore your body. I'm telling you, Snatural Nation, don't ignore your body. On this channel, we're gonna talk about healing your leaky gut. We're gonna talk about chemotherapy and all the side effects that they don't tell you about. We're gonna talk about cleansing and detoxing and the difference between cleansing and detoxing because it is two different worlds. We're gonna talk about everything under the moon when it comes to healing. I also wanna share with you guys all of my natural remedies as far as anti-aging is concerned. Click the like button. Hit the subscribe button. I have so many things to share with you guys. I can't wait to get into it. Drop some notes in the comments. Anybody out there with adult onset Still's disease? Anybody out there suffering from autoimmune conditions? Like, hit your girl up. I love you guys. Thank you so much. Be at peace. I'll see you soon. Good.